Shaan Shahid today. Thank you so much for this interview and thank you for coming to the UK. Tell us a little bit about why you're here.
Well, I'm here to promote the film, and it's not just the film that I'm promoting. I think the script has a lot to say. As far as women are concerned, because in the film, I just wanted to show that life has so many beautiful twists and turns. One doesn't know what happens when you take a certain turn. Decisions determine destiny, that's the tagline of the film. And I personally feel that that's what happens in real life also. Times in our life when we feel that nothing is going right and nothing is going to go right. Yet, there is something that happens to you suddenly. And I think that positive energy in that person, whoever is coming to your life, that changes a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So this film is all about human relations, it's about human emotions, it's about normal people. It's not about divas and it's not about Angelina Jolie's of the world. It's about the girl next door. It's about that normal person who feels that her life has ended, or that person who thinks he's too late on something.
Mm.
That I'm this age now and I'll just take how life comes every day and how life is going to treat. No, you still have a chance, because your decision, whatever you decide today, is going to change your destiny. So it's more like a therapy for me. When I was watching this film, when I was writing this film, when I was directing this film, that was the main thing in my head, that I want people to actually come and see that message where they find their own goodness, where they find their own destination.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why it's called ARTH, the destination, because we all have to go to that destination. There are so many ways of going to it, but somehow we lose the directions. And apart from that, we have an accident. We lose more direction, divorce and being alone, getting old, or not holding on to life. And so all these questions are answered through these four people. There's a passionate love, there's emotional love, there's a soulmate, and this, that finding that your own self. For example, Uzma is a person who's just next door and nobody even realizes that she's alive.
Mm-hmm.
So she's such a normal looking person, and she's not a diva, she's not a film star. Yet she makes her own space in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
When you start watching your film. Same as Ali the singer, when you see him, he's a person who was hit in the 90s. So he's trying to hold back because he made a decision in that time that changed his destiny. And yet life has given him another chance, because the chances are never gone. They're not far away from you. It's your decision to take that decision. So if you take that decision, it's a different life altogether. It's somebody who loves you. Find somebody who's there for you, and suddenly that red color starts looking good. Sometimes it's just, for me, it's a therapy, I swear. I would never say this for a film, but I think all those four characters go through such an entwined emotional impact, and then how they come out of it and they find their destinations. So it was really important for me to target and see how a normal person would fall in love.
Fantastic.
So it doesn't have to be Cinderella all along. There are other things in life. And when life pushes you hard and makes you think that this is the end, that is actually the beginning. Always beautiful to shoot in London.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's amazing. London is so picturesque, shootable, like I say. And the London people are so great, because they never look at the camera. I get a good book, get a nice sandwich.
Lovely.
Get some coffee. Don't forget to read British Muslim Magazine. It's a great source. And whenever I come here, I pick up a copy and go to my favorite spot.